Mom in the Know is here, Julie Findlay, one of my favorite girls in the whole wide world. Aww, you know you
thanks.
Are. When there's a big game on, when you're yep. entertaining at home, snacks and food, really important, and you got to set up.
I do have you set up, and the other most important thing is you do not want to be in the kitchen the entire time the game is on.
So, not just the game, but when yeah. you're entertaining, period, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
It's terrible.
Unless you have a lovely open concept kitchen,
yes.
which we do, but there is something that goes with my ADD that I can't actually cook and talk to you
and
at some time.
Same
so I'd
time.
Rather have it all prepared. So Foodland Ontario, I love it because they're always simple, easy, their recipes are easy to follow, and they have everything in season. So when you never know it's in season, it's coming on.
Okay.
So right now we've got peppers, we've got all colors, we've even got hot peppers. Ontario hot peppers Ooh. Are good, and
okay,
with some garlic.
Cooking?
You know what? We're doing a black bean and beef chili. So what I've already done is I've just browned some beef. It's just stewing okay. beef, which is nice and affordable. And you're just cutting it into chunks, and you're going to just mix it with a little bit of cumin, chili, and flour, and just brown it. You're okay. going to put it in your crock pot.
Oh, if, we're doing the crock
oh,
pot thing?
I love the crock
so
pot.
So do I.
It's
so
one of those things you could just let
yes.
go. Yes.
And it tastes better sometimes when it's been cooking for
It does,
hours.
And it makes your house smell so good.
You're right.
So you've already
Absolutely.
Got a little bit of spice in there. What I've done is just a tablespoon of olive oil. I've got Ontario garlic, which is nice and strong right now.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got yellow and orange peppers and two onions. And I'm just going to saute that, get it going. But in the meantime, I'm going to add a little bit of protein. So some people take their tomatoes and they freeze them over the summer in their freezer.
Yep.
I eat them too quickly, so I just went with canned tomatoes. You take one fluid ounce of 28 mm-hmm. of diced tomatoes, going to just
Let's
put that in.
Okay.
And then black beans, lots of grape fiber, two of those, which is about 4 cups. You're going to put that in.
Okay.
We're already halfway done. We're going to let that saute. While we do, we're going to start our dessert. Okay, I'm just going to let that go.
Just
put it
saying.
On low for about 8 hours.
Just saying.
Okay, this is super fun. So everybody loves brownies. Everybody loves icing. But it's a nice twist to it. It's sweet potato brownies. So one sweet potato is about a cup of sweet potato when you mash it. Easy
sweet
way to do it, if you have a
brownies.
Microwave at home,
yes.
you're just going to slice off the ends. You're going to poke it around. You're going to put it in the microwave for 4 minutes.
Okay.
You're going to flip it over for another 4 minutes.
Okay.
You're going to let it cool. You're going to peel off the skin, and you're going to mash. And there you go. 1 cup of sweet potatoes.
Okay, I'm not sure I'm sold on these.
No, no, no. You're going to love it. You're going to try one before we've even done
Kay.
This. So
Kay.
I'm going to do all the work. But this Kay. Is a sweet potato. We've got some brown sugar. And the best part of this combination is maple syrup. So
oh.
you've got a 1/4 cup of maple syrup with this lovely sweet potato. You've got the moisture right there. So what I also have done ahead of time is I've taken 1/2 cup of butter
mm-hmm.
with 2 ounces, which is 1/4 cup of chocolate chips. And I've melted that together. I know you're looking for it right there.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to pour that in. Again, you don't need to bring out any big blenders. This is a mix only. You've got your oven already preheating at 350. You've got some parchment paper here because everybody hates the mess. I'm going to add one after it's cooked. 1 egg, you can crack the other egg in there because I know
okay.
you always like to be involved.
I do.
I know.
And I'm a
Cooking
good egg
is
cracker.
Fun. You are a good egg cracker.
I am a good egg cracker.
There's so much good things about eggs,
and
too.
And no
like,
shells
so
in there.
Good for you. I know.
So good.
And you cracked it on the edge. A lot of chefs would be saying you cracked it on the bottom. But
oh,
you're
darn.
Seeing you're so good. That's doesn't
okay,
matter.
Well, thank
so
you
got
for being
that
so lenient.
Mixing. Here you've got, obviously, your wet. This is your
yep.
dry. You start stirring. I've got just a cup of flour. I've also got a cup of cocoa. You're going to be getting cocoa in your pantry anyways because the holidays are coming up. Everybody likes to bake. And you've got a teaspoon of baking powder and a little
okay.
bit of salt. You're going to pour it right in here.
Okay.
I'm going to mix it together. Again, you don't have to grease your pan because you've got the parchment paper.
Okay.
And we're going to pour it into our pan.
Sweet
we're going to leave it
brownies.
In the, I know,
All
sweet
right.
potato brownie.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to let you to start chewing on that sweet potato brownie because I'm just, is that okay? Are
yeah.
you out?
Yeah. Oh, no, I'm
just
totally
have a little
getting
taste.
To the sweet potato brownie.
Okay.
I'm just letting you know I'm not a big sweet potato fan.
Oh, no, you're not even going to taste the sweet potato.
Oh, okay.
Have you not heard all this trickiness?
We'll see.
We have been trying to put veggies in all of our baked goods for kids for years, and they have no idea. It's brilliant.
So, okay, so this
okay.
is a mom's trick to
This is
add
a mom's trick to. And for her friends and for her kids. We're just going to pour that in. But you know what? I shouldn't have done that because I want to show you how easy the icing is. All kids like a little bit of icing. What are you
okay.
thinking?
Okay.
Is
okay.
there a taste to it? Do you taste it?
No.
You probably do taste it.
Well, I don't taste the sweet
You know what
potato.
I should have done? I should have blindfolded you first and made you taste it and then made it, because then you would have had no preconceived ideas.
It's very good.
It is very good. So the icing?
You would never know that this was sweet potato.
No. See, that's what I told you. Yeah. Icing's super easy. I've melted a quarter cup of chocolate chips. I'm going to just put in, this is lovely, a quarter cup of yogurt.
Oh,
this is great.
That's good for
Actually,
you
I even lied. It's a cup of yogurt, so it's even better.
This has to be lower in calories,
I know.
Too, isn't it?
It is lower in calories and lower in sugar, because a lot of it's natural with the maple syrup.
Okay.
But this is the icing sugar, which is, as I'm really low in sugar with my cup and a half of icing sugar. You're going to mix that together, and you're going to put it over top of your brownies once they cool down, and then it's good and hardened. So you probably want to talk, okay. Eh?
We've got about a minute
Okay,
left.
Why don't we bring it back over? So see, you can smell the garlic. It's nicely sauteed. It's like 3 to 4 minutes. We've already got our brownies done in that time.
Yep.
I'm turning this off. I'm putting it in the slow cooker, and I'm going to leave the slow cooker going for six hours.
6 hours.
Six wow. hours. Okay, but that's great because you can do it the night
Absolutely.
Before.
And you're in the
yeah.
living room with your friends
exactly.
instead of being a slave over the couch.
And what's super nice about it, crusty bread, making it look good.
There we go.
Yeah.
This is the end product. Thank
it's
you so much,
good.
Miss Julie.
Thank you.
We will be back with a lot more daytime. Stay tuned. We'll be back right after this.